concert tonight. And they're super players and they're real loud and we love them. So, our next piece is the Blue Danube by Strauss. Does anybody in this audience remember seeing the movie 2001 A Space Odyssey? No? Am I telling my age? Okay. In that movie, this piece, Strauss's Blue Danube, was actually played in the scene where they saw a spaceship docking with a space station in that movie. So if you watched that, you've heard this. The Blue Danube waltz was also used at the end of that movie too. But as a side note, the piece was used as the gastrointestinal bypass surgery music in the 2003 film Super Size Me. So if anybody knew about that, I didn't see that movie, maybe you did. So now you'll get to hear our version of the Blue Danube.
Thank you.
Thank you. If the mic is on, does that interfere with the music? Did it make any difference? Okay. All right, thank you. So our next piece is Thunder and Lightning Polka. And it's kind of an interesting thought that when this music was written, a polka was considered a sort of a street dance. If you can imagine, it's kind of like if we would do a waltz or a two-step at a festival. Everybody who was anybody back then would dance the polka in the streets. So this piece was written as party music in its time. And it needs to remind us that we should never take classical music too seriously, because a lot of it was not serious music in its time. So this piece that you're fixing to hear is intended to reproduce the sounds of thunder and lightning with clever use of drums and cymbals. So you'll be able to hear that and hear our weather section as we play. Please, guys. It's entitled Scheherazade, arranged by Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov. And this man wrote this piece of music about a woman whose name was Scheherazade. And each night, she would tell her murderous husband a suspenseful tale, and she wouldn't tell him the ending. So she would preserve her life for the next day so that she could tell her husband more of this tale. He couldn't kill her because he wanted to hear the end of the story. So something tells me this was not the happiest marriage I'd ever heard of. But it did make for a very beautiful piece of music, and we liked it. So here's Scheherazade.
Thank you. Thank you.
for your beautiful, beautiful dancing. Thank you, I worry about those things. Thank you. Our next piece is called New World Coming, and tonight is the world premiere. It's never been heard before in public. I am not a composer, but during the COVID pandemic, I did feel motivated to write my very first piece of music for the orchestra to play. And likely probably be the last piece of music I ever write also. If you follow the melody carefully, you should be able to tell the happy time before the pandemic, then the distressing years when so many of us lost loved ones to this disease, and then ending on a happier, more optimistic note. So, world premiere, new world coming.
Thank you.
So our next piece will be on a happier note. So the last one was about New World Coming. And this one is entitled The New World Symphony. So that's a happier idea, that we can feel like we're already here. And Dvorak's beautiful New World Symphony is very dramatic, and it's triumphant, and brings us back to a more upbeat. Here's an interesting point, if I can recover enough to say it, but I found this interesting. John Williams, who wrote the music to Star Wars, has always insisted that his music has nothing to do with the New World Symphony. But when you listen to the music at the beginning of the movie Jaws, it sounds just like this. And not only that, even Baby Shark starts out like this. It really, really does. So see if you agree with me. but we love it. And it's a beautiful old Irish folk song. And it appears to be a lament that was written about a loved one buried in a graveyard in Scotland. And this song recalls their wonderful times together that they had, and now feeling like his life is at an end. He thinks back about their past and he remembers the old days fondly. It remains one of the most beautiful Irish airs, and our string players tonight will play it for you. No Winds. And the piano. Thank you. fourth movement of the Brahms Symphony No. 1. So when Brahms wrote this first piece of music, it took him 22 years until he was satisfied with it. We're going to play it faster than that. The heat up here plays with the instruments, so it's been a bit of a problem to see. So excuse us, but now we're playing.
Thank you.
last piece for the evening. I'd like to mention to all of you that the Eunice Symphony Orchestra is an all-volunteer group of musicians who play music for the sheer joy of it. They volunteer and I volunteer. So if anybody in the audience, if you play an instrument and you would like to join this fun group, you let me know and I will give you the details. The Eunice Symphony Orchestra, the only orchestra on the Cajun Prairie, is supported by our advertisers, our sponsors, and our ticket sales, people like you. So I'd like to thank all of our advertisers, which you can thank them too by supporting their businesses. And these people had to wait 2 years for their listing to appear in our program because we were 2 years without a concert. Thank you also to our sponsor, LSUE, who has adopted us as part of the LSUE Performing Arts Series and allowed us to use this beautiful health technology auditorium on the campus. A major big thanks to Dr. Tony Baltakis and his wife Donna for handling the arrangements and all of the details for us to be able to use this building. Also, I want to thank KEUN, KJJB, and the Eunice News for giving us publicity. A special thanks also to Shayna Broussard and Ivy Carrier, the dancers from the Performing Arts Theater of the South, for their graceful performance. Thanks also to the City of Eunice and to Mona Clavier for allowing us to use the Northwest Center as our rehearsal hall. And of course, thank you especially to my favorite orchestra on the face of this earth, the Eunice Symphony Orchestra, for your dedication to rehearsing and to performing. You guys are great. And above all, we thank our Father in Heaven for his wonderful gift that he gives us of music. Our last piece is Beethoven's Egmont Overture. wish I would know that. We do have a little something planned. Thank you for asking. We're going to follow up this with the Tempest. And so that's a really nice piece of music. And following that, we'd also like to invite our dancers to come up for a final bow.